All right, it's Friday, February 20th. Let's talk PlayStation. All right, let's get into our first news story. Sony will be starting a new charity initiative called PlayStation Heroes. This will be an application you can download on PlayStation 4 and purchases you make on that application for, say, games, add-on content, things like that. That's going to go to certain charities like Make-A-Wish, the V Foundation, USO. This basically connects certain people with possible celebrities. So, say you make a purchase, you're entered into a drawing for you to possibly play online or in person with a certain celebrity. Like, I believe they got Shaun White on there, Snoop Dogg, a couple other like athletes. So just basically a straight up charity initiative. This is going to be an application you can download, and games you buy and stuff like that through the application. It's like a drawing to actually possibly win with those celebrities. And they're going to be, each of these charities is going to get like $100,000 initially from Sony. There's like nothing bad about this. Like, obviously this is a good thing, so you know, there's that. Let's move into some sales discussion. One specific analyst firm believes that Sony is going to be outselling the Xbox One by a marginal percent throughout its entire life cycle, about 40%. They're saying the PlayStation 4 could at some point reach about 80 million systems worldwide sold by the end of 2019, whereas they believe the Xbox One will be sitting around 57, 53 million consoles, I think they said, something like that. So Sony will have a pretty significant lead over the Xbox One throughout its life cycle. Not necessarily surprising. I pretty much feel that way too. I have always said, like, I think Sony's in a pretty good spot where they're probably going to lead this entire console generation. I still believe Microsoft will take North America at some point. I believe they'll do it this year, but if they don't do it this year, I think they'll do it at some point. But Sony does have most other territories pretty much on lockdown. But, you know, this is just one firm. You're going to see all sorts of sales predictions for how many years now until we finally get the real results at the end of the life cycle. They also believe 2019 is going to be the actual peak of the console sales for all these machines. So, you know, we'll see just how long they really have a good foothold in the market. But while we're speaking of sales and profitability and things like that, let's move into our next news story, which is Sony CEO Kaz Hirai discussed the possibility of what Sony wants to do in the future and how they want to stay profitable, because the company is going to be announcing its like sixth or seventh fiscal year in a row where they're going to be taking a loss, something like that, something along those lines. It's hard to keep up with at this point because they're always losing so much money, but some quarters they actually do well in certain divisions, but in total the company keeps losing money. But the one thing CEO Kaz Hirai said is that moving forward, they might possibly drop mobile and television, which for a while now I've been saying they need to drop PC and television. They finally sold off PC. PC is finally done with. And in fact, the Vio business is finally releasing its own Vio PCs now that they're independent from Sony and everything. So they're finally like doing their own thing and whatnot. Sony's gotten rid of them. TV, Sony's been doing bad for a while now. With mobile, Sony keeps losing to a lot of other cheaper manufacturers in Asia and things like that. They're just not being at all profitable on it. So moving forward, they're saying that they wouldn't necessarily sell those businesses, but that they you know, it's certainly a possibility, right? And they're not going to keep focusing on those divisions. So I have to believe right now they're assessing the situation, like, you know, what are we going to do here? Are we going to sell them off? Are we going to spin them off? Are we going to let them do their own thing? Are we going to try and stay, you know, I don't even know. I feel like the only option is to definitely get rid of them, or at the very least make drastic changes to them. But the good news is that they are looking at PlayStation to move forward with profitability, right? I've been saying this for a while now. They make money with PlayStation. That is a good division for them, and they're going to keep moving forward with that. They're also going to keep moving forward with music and in basic, like, general entertainment services that Sony provides, so music and Sony Pictures. They're going to keep going with that. They make image sensors for the iPhone, which they're doing, you know, they make a lot of money off of. I'm sure they want to keep that up. Right now, actually, another past news story this week was that Sony is currently investing in self-driving technology, like self-driving cars. Like, they invested $800,000 into a Japanese firm that's building, like, robot cars. So this doesn't necessarily mean that Sony's going to, like, make vehicles, like a Sony car, but rather they're going to be supplying possible technology for autonomous vehicles in the near, you know, in the possible future. So, you know, that's a good profitability standpoint for Sony. They're a big electronics company. They can provide, like they're doing right now with the iPhone. Instead of necessarily releasing their own products. They can be suppliers to other companies, and they can make a lot of money that way too. So, but it's good news that PlayStation is definitely going to be a focus for Sony in the future. So one really big news story this past week was The Last Guardian. The Last Guardian recently this past week it was revealed that the trademark for the game was abandoned. So what, you know, how that usually, you know, the trademarks usually work and how that whole process works is, you know, you file a trademark. If you don't use it, they're going to send the company, the entity, a notice saying, you know, you can renew this license or whatnot. And if you're going to use it, you have to send like case files and all this crap. You know, it's a very legal process, but you basically have to prove that you're going to be using the trademark in some way, shape, or form. By sending raw materials or something along those lines, but you do have to like recertify it, right? And it got to the point where Sony basically wasn't providing anything to say like, we're going to keep using this trademark for The Last Guardian, and the trademark was recently abandoned. Sony has responded within that same time frame for this past week, saying that they are in fact still developing The Last Guardian. The game is still being made. It's still coming. They have nothing to announce at this time. The same usual, you know, BS they usually give us about this game. And the thing is, back in 2012, the trademark for The Last Guardian was abandoned back then too. So it was abandoned in 2012, re-upped. Then there was, you know, the news story, what, 6 months ago, 8 months ago, where IGN reported that The Last Guardian was canceled. And that was a big false news story where IGN had a bad source. And then Sony had to respond again saying, we are still working on The Last Guardian. Now here we are in 2015. Trademark abandoned again. Sony saying they are working on it. The team is still working on it. So, you know, whenever we talk about The Last Guardian, there's nothing we can really say about it. We have nothing to go on at all. Absolutely nothing. We can only go on the small little tidbits of details that we ever get, or the fact that Sony keeps telling us that they're working on it. That's what they're saying. They're saying it's actively being worked on. I'd have to imagine it's being worked on by two people at the most if they're making this kind of progress. Or at maybe, you know, it's getting to a point where they're developing this game and it's going in a completely different direction. Like the last few trailers we've seen. I'd have to imagine the game looks completely different now. Or it's going in a completely different sort of scenario where it's different environments, different characters. Maybe that flying bird Jesus monster's gone now. We don't know, right? We haven't seen any new source material for the game. It could be completely different now, which would be totally understandable because it's been so long. You got all this time that you're wasting away. It's got to be for some sort of reason like that, right? So, anyway, I really don't know what else I can say. That's the thing. We have no clue at all what's going on with that game. It's just a matter of when we'll actually see it at E3 or something, hopefully, maybe. I'm sure we all get our hopes up deep down inside for the people that bought a PS3 for that game. It's got to come to PS4 now at this point, right? Who knows? We'll wait and see. Channel update. It's funny, The Order 1886 comes out today. Not reviewing very well, obviously. I'll still get it. I still want to review it and play it myself and give you my perspective on it. And I will still be let's playing it, so you'll get my blind playthrough and blind reactions of it. My legit reactions of it. Granted, I'm sure you guys are all, oh, don't act all crazy and stupid like all those other YouTubers. Now, when I do a blind let's play, I stay pretty much silent through the whole thing and give genuine reactions like, oh, this is annoying from a combat perspective, or, oh, that story element was really interesting. Here's my thoughts on it, blah, blah, blah. It's a very laid-back scenario, but I'll still be doing that. And it'll probably be up as soon as I can get it, so I do work tomorrow. And I'll get home around like 8 o'clock or something and start playing it. And I still gotta, you know, record the footage, edit it, and upload it. And uploading a high quality footage of like The Order is probably gonna take like fucking forever. So the part one of The Order probably won't be up till like Saturday, but I will still do it. And the real good news is this coming week, starting Monday, my hours at my job are going down. Finally. So not only can I enjoy The Order 1886, but I'll have way more time to finally start making YouTube videos. So I'll finally get back on that grind, hopefully. Anyway, that about does it for me on this episode of Let's Talk PlayStation. I'm Ryan Benecke. Thank you guys so much for talking with me. I'll see you guys all next Friday.